हेलो, हाय एवरीवन।
हाय। बस
कैसे स्टार्ट। सो यू आर एबल टू मेक द अकाउंट the Power BI account.
Yeah, but while publishing, I mean, while sharing, right, I can't able to share
Where are you trying to share it?
on the Power BI service.
Can you share your screen? You can show me.
Yeah.
Yeah, same problem with me also. The send button is not enabling.
Yeah, my first question. See, these are all the workspaces I have created, Amit. And this is my private workspace, right? My workspace is my private folder, and workspaces is the public folder, right?
Correct.
Yeah, if I click here and create a workspace, this my workspace is changing to the name which I'm creating currently. Why is that so?
So it shows that, no, that which workspace you will be looking at right now. So if you click on any workspace over here,
okay,
right, so that means now it is showing the files of that workspace.
Then what will happen to my other folders in the my workspace, my private folder?
That's in the workspaces only. Click on workspaces
here.
Workspaces at the top.
Okay. I was doing some research in recent and I went to my workspace. Okay. See, these are all the two things. Yeah, this is my report. If I click to share and tried to give your name, okay. Yeah, see.
See, you cannot give any email ID outside your domain. So that is where this, see, otherwise, that is why you cannot. The Microsoft says that you have to create a Microsoft you should have Office account, right? If you like, if you click on specific people, yes, click on this.
Yeah. Should I click this?
No, you can avoid. Just click on apply.
Okay.
If you will give my ID of some Gmail and also, it will not allow me to share it.
No, I tried to give your PBA on Microsoft.com. Even then, I'm not getting.
You can't give it. So what is your ID that you have created? What is the ID that you created?
Mine. You're asking mine.
Yes.
It's Deepa1526@Deepa1526.com. On Microsoft.com.
So you will only be able to share it with the where you know domain is @deepa15.onmicrosoft.com.
The domain you are saying. Okay. I thought whoever is having this Microsoft account, I thought I can share.
No. Only that domain name.
Okay. While working, right, where do we need to go and share? Want to get some idea. See, these
if you see over here, like if you click on the first link, that means in that case, what will happen is all the people in your company, they will be able to see this report. Okay. Anyone who will have the link of this report, they will be able to see it. Second is people with existing access. I mean, the people to whom you have already given the access, you want it should be only visible to them. The people to whom you gave them access previously. In that case, you go with the second option. And when you click on the third option, that is specific people, that is if you want to share it with some 5 people, 7 people in your team who should be able to see it. So you use that third option where you put their email address.
Okay. Here in the first option, right, everyone will be having a particular email so that only you can able to share.
Sorry?
this first category, right, organization, since it is an organization, you, me, if we are in same organization, we'll be having the same organization IDs. Okay. But even for practice, I can't share with anyone here.
No, inside your this you can't do it.
Okay.
But you can do one thing, just what you will be able to do in that case is click on the file.
Okay.
And then embed report. Publish to web.
Public. Should I click OK? Sorry, where should I go?
No, it is not done yet. There is some settings change that we have to do. Then, can you click on that again? What's the other thing? Contact admin to enable embed portal.
Oh, sorry. Should I click it again?
Oh, no. I was able to see it.
Sorry, your voice is breaking kind of.
Just give me 1 minute, Deepa. Just give me one
minute. Yeah, sure.
Okay, can you just go one, click on OK on this? Click on the three dots, right, on the top right corner.
Yeah.
No, top right.
Here.
So click on this, click on settings, admin portal.
Okay.
Okay, now scroll down over here. Scroll down. Scroll it down. Down. You will see a publish to web. You see publish to web. Up. I think it went down.
Here.
And over here. Oops. So, you know, just click on this embed codes. Okay. Click on, got it. So, go on that only, tenant settings only.
Here?
Tenant settings, the first option, tenant settings.
Oh, tenant settings, okay.
We all scroll down. We go to the same option.
Here.
Yeah, publish to web. Change this option over here. Choose how embed code works. Yeah, allow existing and new codes. Yeah, click on apply. So your settings will be applied, same in 15 minutes. So now if you will come back, right? If you will just come to your this report over there. Now come to the my workspace.
Should I give apply all?
Now open the report. Yeah, click on file.
This one?
Yes.
Should I click this?
Create embed code.
Should I click this one?
Yes. Publish. See, now this is the link that you have got. Can you share this link over the chat? The first
this one.
Just copy it and share it on the chat.
I couldn't go back to the chat window.
You will be getting from the top.
Yeah. I have sent.
Yeah. See, now what I've done is I just clicked on that link of yours. And now I'm able to see your report. Stop sharing the screen now.
Yeah.
Right, so now I'm using your links and I'm able to open that report over here. Right, so now all the things.
Okay.
Do on this. As well as this, the report gets filtered according to that. Right, so now I can see it.
Since it is public, how can I end? To whoever I am sending this link, they can able to access. I can take in that sense.
Now it has generated a public link of this. That okay. If you will link this share outside your domain also, they will be also.
Okay. Is it like a security breach if I share outside?
Well, it's not a security breach, but it's like sometimes people have to put their reports on their websites and all. So If you need that to do, so you can do it. That.
But do I need to get approval because it will include some confidential data, right, in companies?
That will be a call on that basis. Right?
Like okay.
If the data is confidential, so you definitely will not do that. But if it is something that we know that you know, we have to share it with the other people also, so you will do it.
To go file, embed, click public. Okay, I'll take care of that. I'll see that. Thank you so much, Ramil.
Anyone else who was facing any challenges or issues? So now what we'll do is yesterday, we were talking about this. So now I'll just open up that. The Power BI service again. Okay. So now I hope everyone, others, Deepa. So you are able to publish your reports, Vijay, Lakshmi?
Yeah. Yes.
Okay. See, now you know what happens is like just open one of the reports, right? In the My Workspaces. So what you can do is just open any of the reports right now. I published your report, where has it gone? Yesterday. This was the file day. See, now this file that we published yesterday, right? So, you know, what we can do is, on this file, so I've shown you some very basic functionality, right? Like as in how you can export it, how you can edit it, and right? Now, those are the things that we had seen yesterday. So now what we can do in these reports is, we can actually set up, you know, an automatic refresh, right? You can set up the scheduled refresh, as in, we can set up the times. What will happen is that, at whatever time you set up, the report will get refreshed from your laptop automatically without any manual intervention on your without the intervention of a developer. So for example, you know, you have the data on your laptop, right? This is what I'm saying. You have an Excel file on your laptop, and then the file is placed over here on the cloud. Now what happens is, the data in your Excel file from which this report was made, it gets, you know, the data gets, every day there is new data that gets into that Excel file. So definitely you will want that this report should get updated, right? You will definitely want this report to be updated based on that, whatever data that you are inserting in it. Okay. So for that particular thing, you know, what we do is, basically we have to set up the gateways. You can set up a gateway between the cloud and your laptop. And the idea of that gate and laptop is this, that what is going to happen is, the data will get refreshed at whatever time you will set it up. So for example, you say that every day at 5 p.m., your report on the cloud should get updated. So if you get any new data in Excel, so what Power BI will do is, at 5 p.m., it will hit your system. And it will access that Excel file from which the file was made, and it will pull that updated data and it will refresh the file on the cloud. So you see, nothing otherwise, what happens is, in the manual process, what you have to do is, if you have to refresh the data, that file that you would be having, you will actually have to first of all open that file, right? You will have to refresh that file. So there are a lot of things that you will have to do on that. I open this up. Okay, like this file was made from this. Let us see the file path. See, this file was made from this Excel file, which is placed at my location at this. So in that file, if I update the data, right now what will happen is, I will have to refresh it, and then I will have to publish it again. That is how the data will refresh. Agree, everyone? Right?
Yes.
What we are trying to do is, we are trying to do that refresh automatic, that I do not have to come over here and manually do that process. So in order to do that, what we will need is, you will all have to first install a gateway. So how do you install a gateway? You just have to click on the three dots and you will say download data gateway. So please click on this download data gateway. And from there, click on download personal mode. Right, so you all have to download personal mode, right? So please download this and install this personal mode. What is this gateway? You know, this gateway is like a bridge. It's like a bridge between your cloud and your laptop. Please download the personal mode. Please install that. See, when you install that gateway, what is going to happen is that gateway is going to ask your office ID, this Power BI ID and password. You will have to put that over there. Please, are you all installing it?
Yeah, it is still downloading for me. Should we accept the terms? Okay, yeah, it got installed. Installation was successful.
Is it installing for everyone?
No, for me it's showing as gateway was not found. Please try to reconfigure the gateway.
It will just straightforward process. It will just ask for that email ID once. That's it. Otherwise, all next.
Yeah, that's it. I done that. But last time getting this one, gateway was not found.
You getting some error?
Yeah, gateway was not found. Showing like that.
Can you share your screen? Configure. Put that address. Yeah. Next.
Yeah.
Right, so you are ready to use that.
Yeah. Thank you.
Can close this now, this window. Okay. So I hope everyone is able to do it.
Yes.
So now see this, once this is installed, then just the job is done. So what we do is, you come to your My Workspace. Okay. And for that report, write that report that you want to refresh automatically. Okay, the report that you want to refresh automatically, you will have to come on that data set. Over here, you know, you will see some options. So when you hover this, you see that these options are coming. Just click on schedule refresh. So click on schedule refresh. Okay. On the schedule refresh, you will find the option of gateway connection. In the gateway connection, you will see personal mode gateway, your personal gateway. Do you all see that?
Yeah.
Okay. That's it. Then you come down. Are you seeing data source credentials and this error message would be coming?
Yeah, can't
do
this one.
Yes.
The same message, right? Your data source can't be refreshed.
Yes.
So, then what you do is you just have to click on edit credentials. Okay. And over here you have to choose the option of Windows. You see, you will see that it is showing you the path. That this is the path where this data set is placed. And you just have to click on sign in. And it's done. Okay, just have to click on sign in.
Yeah.
And then what you have to do is you have to click over here on scheduled refresh.
keep your data up to date. Nerd is asking that how and when do you want to update or refresh your data. So just click on that you want the data to be refreshed daily. Select your time zone and add the time. Suppose you want that data should refresh at 6 p.m. every day. You select the time from here. Okay, please do it. Yep. Have you all done this?
Yeah.
Right.
See, now you know what happens is for the refresh to happen, you have to make sure that, you know, like suppose you have set up the time of 6 p.m. Okay. Now at that 6 p.m., your laptop should be on and it should be connected to the internet. These two conditions should be satisfied. Okay, if suppose definitely because you know cloud will be hitting your laptop through the internet only. And if suppose it was not connected to the internet or it was turned off, your data will not refresh. And it will send an email. It will send an email to you that the data couldn't be refreshed due to so and so reason. And if you want to add some more IDs in that, you can do that also, right? These IDs will be again from your domain only, not outside your domain. And you just click on apply and your refresh is scheduled. Now every day at 6 p.m. Power BI will automatically, you know, the service will hit your laptop and bring the updated data. So that's it. As simple as that. Now if you go back to the My Workspace and you will go to the date, come to the data set. If you will check the data set, it will tell you that this on the data set, it will tell you, see, when that refresh is scheduled. So it is telling that this was last refresh at this date and time. Next schedule is next refresh of the data is scheduled at 24th of June at 6 p.m. the time that you have set it up. So it will update every day. Yep, this is clear to all of you.
Amit, you said two conditions, right? One is network and other thing I can't.
The laptop should be on.
Oh, on, okay.
And now you will start receiving the emails from Microsoft. So whenever the data will refresh, you will get an email for that also, that your report was refreshed. And if it will fail, it will give you the email for that also. That the refresh failed.
This one. See, now, you know, like yesterday, what we were discussing was, so we were talking about the Power BI trajectory, right? This is something that we were discussing yesterday, so that we had not covered. So we saw that how you can bring and fetch the data from the Power BI using the import data. So now what we are going to do is, I will click on SQL Server. Okay, the server name is, put the server name that we are using. Okay. And now this time use direct query, the optional direct query. And click on OK. So please select the database and the table. And select that orders table from there. Just a moment, just making the connection. So now see, when you all make a direct query, you will see the data, the same way the data comes up over here in the Power BI, right? If you all would have been able to make it. The only difference that happens over here is that you get the relationship view, but you don't have the data view. You see, the third option is not there. So what exactly is direct query? In the direct query, data is coming directly from SQL Server to the Power BI. Okay, there is... In the import, what happens is the data gets imported in the Power BI and it gets stored in the Power BI file itself. But now because this is a direct query, so what is happening in this is data is coming directly from the source to over here. Now, if you will make any chart, right? If you will make any chart now, suppose I make a chart over here, suppose a normal clustered bar chart. So if I know now make a normal clustered bar chart over here, and what I do is I put categories in it and the sales in it. Okay. So when you make a chart over here, right? So what happens in this case is you see chart is taking a little longer to be get created. It just little more time taking. Why is it that? Because, you know, when you're trying to make a chart, so what Power BI is doing, Power BI is writing a SQL query, and that SQL query is then sent to the database. And then based on that SQL query, the data is fetched for this chart, and then the chart is created. Okay. Like for example, now if you select over here, I make another chart. right? If I make another chart over here, it will suppose I keep the region. The segment and the sales. Right, so now what has happened is there is this chart that is created, right? With this chart, for this chart also, what Power BI would have done is it would have created, or it would have written another query over here. There is another query that would have been written for this. Okay, there would have been another query that would have been written over here for this. So two charts, two queries. Okay, two charts, two queries. So because in direct query, what happens is everything is coming from the database. Nothing is in the Power BI. If I put up a slicer, right? In the slicer, suppose I keep ship mode. So what happens in this case is that when you set up a ship, when you put up the ship mode, so in the ship mode, what is going to happen right now is if you select same day, you see chart is taking a little while to get refreshed, but it is very quick in the import, because when you change a filter, the data is changing, the query is changing. So Power BI is again writing the query and it is hitting the database and then bringing the data. So anytime you change the filter, right? Anytime you're changing the filter, how many queries Power BI is writing? Two queries, one and two, right? Anytime I'm changing the slicer, if I change same day, again, there are two queries that are fired. If I click on first class, again, two queries are fired. Right?
It's like PBA fires each query to that many number of database when a filter is applied.
Sorry?
Which means Power BI queries or fires query to the database for each charts, that many number each of charts.
Yes, yes. And those many queries are written.
Okay.
Okay. So what we do is, you know, when you, this is one second. So you see what happens is, So when you write any query, it fires a query. So now answer this question. See, suppose if I select standard mode, and then if I'm selecting same day, I wanted to see the data for two ship modes. So how many queries got fired?
For each filter, two queries.
Mm-hmm. There are four queries, right? Total.
Yeah, totally four.
Because I wanted to see the rate of same day and standard class. So two queries for this, and so two queries get fired for this, and then two queries get fired for this. So that means total of four queries that are being fired. So see, more and more queries will be fired. It will impact, it will put the load on the database, and it is going to take more time also for you. So what we do is, if you click on the file and you click on options and settings and click on options. Okay, please do that.
Amit, why four? I mean, for this one, it should be one, because this and this. So in one query, same day and standard class could be handled, right?
No, so what you're doing is, when you click on same, when you click on this standard class, data is filtered for standard class in both of them. Right, two queries.
Yeah.
One query of this chart, one query of this chart, two queries. And now when you select standard the same day, now the data again updates. Now it's showing the data of standard class on same day. Two queries again. Yes.
Okay.
So each query has, each chart is one query. This is one query, this is one query. You selected, when you clicked on first value, the chart gets instantly updated for that filter, right?
Okay.
Now when you select same day also, then again the chart instantly filters. Yes. There are four queries that are getting fired.
Okay.
So what I'm trying to do now is I want to reduce those queries. So I go to the options and settings and I click on options. So from there, what we do is, you know, if you will come to the very last option, there is an option of query reduction. There's an option of query reduction. In the query reduction, you just have to say that in the slicer, add an apply button. Now, what will happen with the apply button is, please watch it. Just, it's just a single change that you have to do. You will get an apply button on the filter. So if you suppose now select standard class, second class, I mean, you select two, three values together. See, data is not getting filtered. It is waiting for the apply button. When you click the apply button, then the filter will be applied. So now in this case, only two queries get fired instead of four queries.
Yes,
getting
this
it?
Yeah.
Because previously the filters were working instantly. Mm-hmm. But now if you are changing a filter, you have to give a command of apply so that Power BI gets to know that the system has to apply those settings.
So here, how many number of queries will be returned then if I do it with an apply button in slicer?
Sorry?
So how many number of queries will be returned here then if I use the apply
button? Two queries.
I mean, per chart, per query, that is same.
Per query is one chart.
No, I can't hear you properly.
Can you hear me?
Yeah.
So I'm saying one chart is one query.
Yeah. Okay. No, with right. This, I'm just trying to differentiate. After using this apply button, right? If I'm applying three filters, I mean, the sheep mode is three. So how many number of queries return? Two?
Two.
Okay.
Right, because see, how is the filter being applied? So now, previously when you were selecting only one value, you were saying select query where shipping mode is equal to second class.
Okay.
And then you selected another option also, the query changed to where shipping mode equal to second class or same day. So, but previously the same thing was happening instantly. So whenever we were making a selection, you all saw that the chart was changing.
Yes.
Correct? But if you see now, the chart is not changing because I have not clicked on apply. That means the query is not fired. It is still waiting for it that what selections you want to make. So when you make two selections, it writes that query that where shipping mode equal to same day or second class and it fires it. So two queries, one query for this chart, one query for this chart gets updated.
Okay. Okay. Getting it.
So now what you do? Huh?
Are we able to see the queries?
No, you can't see the queries.
Okay.
You won't be able to see it. So for that, you know, you have there are some mechanisms. You will have to install DAX Studio and all. It's in another application that can be used.
Okay.
So now you know with the direct query, what happens is now publish this report. Okay, just publish this report now. So let's publish it. I'm just publishing it in a different workspace. Let's publish it.
Okay, so when you publish a direct query file and you open it, right, you will see the charts will come all empty. Nothing will be visible over here. Can anyone tell me a reason why?
There is no data set.
So why don't we have any data in this?
Because it's direct query. The Power BI doesn't itself doesn't have data.
Data view is not there in direct query.
Data view is just to view the data that we see in the Power BI desktop. So that is not available in the Power BI service. See, what was the connection mode? That was direct in the direct query. What we did was the data was coming directly from the SQL server. Okay. So now when the data is coming directly from the SQL server, so that means your Power BI service should also be able to connect with that data source. Correct? If you will change the chart over here, your Power BI service will hit the query on the SQL database. It will update the data. Getting it?
Okay, since there is a direct connection from source to destination, if we make any changes here, that will also get reflected, right? On the source.
So this was the data source.
Okay.
The SQL server, this was the data source.
Mm-hmm.
You made a connection of your Power BI desktop and you made your report in the Power BI desktop over here.
Okay.
Now this data source is connecting, this data file is connecting with the data source and it is writing all the queries.
Okay.
Then what you have published, then what you have done is you have published this report on the Power BI service cloud. Correct?
Okay.
Now this report that you have published, now this cloud also has to interact with the same data source so that it can update the data. If you select anything, the cloud should be able to talk to the data source.
Okay.
No, tell me, should this happen or not?
But if it happens like this, then entire data source will get changed, right? If any changes on the cloud happens, this will get automatically changed.
Any change happens, what changes in terms of cloud?
I couldn't imagine in that way. If I change anything on the PBI, I'm just assuming since it is a direct connection, any changes will definitely get reflected on the data source.
The data doesn't change. Data is not changing. What is changing? The report is changing. Right? When you are making any selections, when you're filtering the data, so what is happening is this report is changing. Why this report is changing? Because the data is changing. So it is just hitting the data source. And based on the criteria, it is getting the data from the source, right? This is what is happening?
Yeah, getting from the data source, yes.
So are we changing anything in the data source?
No, we are making changes in the PBI side.
We are making changes in the PBI file.
Yeah.
So PBI file is getting the data from the data source directly.
Yes.
Now the data was not there in the PBI. Because when the data is, if the data would happen in the PBI, the data also plus the file both go on the cloud. Now file has gone on the cloud, but the data hasn't. Right? Data is still in the data source only because it was a direct connection. So now if I want that the data should refresh on my Power BI service account, that file has to interact with the data source. Only then it will be able to show the data in it.
Yes.
Getting it? If the report is placed over here, you change the filter on that report. From where will it get the data? From where will the data come? It will come from the data source only, na?
Of course, yeah.
So your cloud should have that authority or the access to the data source. Because when you are making this Power BI file, you are doing all the things on your local machine.
Yes.
So in that case, you were able to talk and you were able to see. But yep. Now what is happening is the file has gone to the cloud now. That's a different platform and the data source is on your local platform. So how will they talk to each other? You need to make a connection between them.
You need a gateway for that.
Yes.
Right? So yes, that is the same thing. Now, just that is the reason, because right now what is happening is my report is ready. See, report is published. You see this apply button. Apply button is visible. Why is it visible? Because it was there in the report. This apply button is visible, but the data is not visible. Why the data is not visible? Because it's a direct query. The data is not present in this cloud right now because there is no connection between the data source. If I establish the connection, this Power BI service will also be able to pull the data from my data source and my report will start working. So what I will have to do now is I will just have to set up the gateway. So I'll go to my I'll go to that workspace where I published this report. So in which one did I publish? Then I published in the ABC. Right, so in this ABC, you can see this data set is visible, but this data set doesn't have any data right now in it. So what we'll have to do is we'll have to follow the same steps. We will have to click on schedule refresh. Right, you will have to set up the gateway connection, right? This data set has been configured by this. Now we need to use the gateway from which we have to install it. So for that, what I need to do is, you know, okay. So now, you know, for this, for working with the database servers, you actually have to install another gateway also. That is standard. So just watch it for a minute, then you can all try it at your end. So you just have to, in the same way from that link where, you know, you install the personal gateway, you will have to install the standard mode also, and all the same things will start coming over there. So if I click on add to gateway, and over here I will just say Windows, and I will say add. Now what has happened is just that was required. So my gateway connection is done. It is going to ask me. See, now it is saying that my Power BI, that gateway, that connection, this is the gateway, the standard gateway that I made. Now based on that, this is running on my laptop. And I say this new data source and apply. So now my Power BI connection has been made. Right now my Power BI connection has been made. And if I now go to this report, I will just have to refresh it once. I'll refresh the data. Right, it will take a little while. So refreshed that. Is it done? Just take a while to update the report. Right, so you always just have to install one more gateway, that is standard, the standard gateway. The standard gateway is something that works only with the servers, and personal gateway is required when you have to work with the Excel files. Okay, so this is how you see now direct query connection is made. And if we'll go come into the my workspaces, sorry, this ABC workspaces, and you click on this schedule refresh. In the direct query, you know, you can refresh the data like sorry guys, it's having a really cold today. Okay. So in this direct query, what happens is you have a refresh frequency that you can refresh the data every 15 minutes. Every 15 minutes, what will happen is the SQL server, right? The Power BI service, it will hit the It will hit your database and it will keep on refreshing the data every 15 minutes, right? After every 15 minutes, your data will be refreshed. Got it? So the only thing that you will all now need is just install that data gateway. Previously you installed personal gateway. Now you will have to install the standard gateway. Once you will install that, you will publish your file. You will be able to, You will just have to set up that gateway and you will be done. Okay.
After installation and after publishing, and the scheduling steps are same.
That is same. That is the same. They are the same.
Even though I feel like I'm getting the differentiation, but I feel like I'm lost somewhere, because if my client is giving my file, I'm going to the cloud, I'm taking the snapshot and saving a copy in my local system.
Which file? Like, what is the file right now?
Like the Excel one or anything from the cloud or SQL database, anything. I am just taking a copy and I'm just saving. You said manual refresh. You need to change the data source file and you have to come and refresh in the PBI desktop and you have to republish it again. That is in the case if I am just working on the file that is present locally on my system. Is that right?
Yeah.
Okay, if my file changes, if my client is giving it another file, I'm taking that copy and I'll be replacing that file, which I working in my local system. Is that right? Then only I can refresh it. The updated one. If I am getting another file, see, if I'm working in a file today and my another team member is giving me the updated one tomorrow, I will come and replace the data source file, right?
But it should have the same name.
Okay.
Because when you make your connection with the file, right? When you make the connection with your Power BI file, so it saves the file path, right? It knows that okay, the file name and the file path has to be this.
Okay.
And the file is placed at this name. Now, if you put another file and you delete this file, Power BI will find this file only, right? It is going to go into the D drive Ericsson folder and it is going to find this file. Yeah. Now, if the file name is changed, so it will not be able to find it. So you will not be able to refresh the data. So you provided if you are updating that file, you have to make sure that the file name is same.
Okay.
Right. So when you publish it, so that becomes, you will have to manual. So I'm not sure like you were asking the question on the refresh or on the direct query.
Yeah, this is fine. But you explained the scheduling our jobs, right? Automatic scheduling. In which scenario I need to go for that one?
So where the data is updating every time, right? If you suppose daily get a new file or in your Excel file, you daily update new data. So if you're adding new data on a daily basis, what will happen is if daily you will add new data, you will have to update your file also.
Yeah.
So how will you do it manually? How do you refresh the data? You click on this refresh.
So
this file is on your local system?
Yes.
So data will refresh in your local file. Will it refresh in the cloud?
No.
In order to refresh in the cloud, what you will have to do? You will have to publish it again.
Yes.
So if you have 100 reports with you and daily you have to update those 100 reports, will you be able to do?
No, that is not the good way and it is not possible.
Not possible? So to remove that manual intervention, what I did was I said that let's go to the cloud and let us set up a functionality that the cloud itself will take care of that refresh. Developer will not have to do anything in that case. So that is where I'm setting up the refresh.
Getting it provided your location should not change.
Correct. So if you change the location, you change the file name. So the system will not get to know, right? So if suppose I say that, Deepa, in the D drive in the Ericsson folder, I have kept a file for you, sample superstore. And now I, without telling you, I change the file path. Will you be able to find that file?
No.
Right? So that is the same thing that is happening with the computers also. In the computer, I have told to the computer that the file is placed in this drive, this folder, this is the file. So it is just going to that path and picking up the file. But if you change the file path, if you change the file name, definitely the system, the computers won't be able to get to know that.
And one more question, Amit, since you are the experienced one, you are the right person to ask this. See, if you are working in a team, and where will you start developing? You can't do it in your personal. You will be having a shared drive or folder to start working on your development so that the files will be picked from that location. It will get refreshed due to the scheduled job. Will it go in that manner or how it goes?
I'll be able to take this question not tomorrow, you know, because I just have to start the next session.
Yeah. Sure. Just thought.
Definitely, I'll take this question tomorrow, right? I'll definitely answer this.
Yeah.
And tomorrow we'll also be done with the Power BI.
Clarity on that, we can able to view how we can work, because things concept wise we got it, but some confusions. That's it.
So just try it once at your end. See, one refresh we have already done. That is of the Excel one. You just have to install the data gateway and you have to set up the refresh of the direct query. That's it. Just do it, and if you still get any questions, so definitely I'll help you out tomorrow.
Yeah, sure. No problem. Thank you for the session.
Okay. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, Amit. Thanks.
Thank you.